give God all the glory and honor and praise. Good morning. I am Deacon Joseph Harris. I bring forth you greetings from the Amazing Grace Missionary Baptist Church, where Pastor Curtis Root Sr. is our pastor. Our First Lady is Brenda Wooten. Our church motto is, "This is the day which the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it." Before I go into our scripture reading, I would like to give you some words of encouragement to our mothers. Number one, let it go. Number two, be yourself. Number three, give it time. Number four, suit your passion. Number five, have fun. Number six, make a difference. And number seven, always smile. Our scripture reading will be coming from Proverbs chapter 31, verses 10 through 31. Who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above rubies. The heart of her husband doeth safely trust in her, so that he has no need of spoil. She will do him good and not evil all the days of her life. She will seek wool and flax and work willing with her hands. She is like the merchant ship. She brings her food from afar. She riseth also while it is yet night, and give meat to her household, and a portion to her maids. She considered a field and buy it. With the fruit of her hand, she planned a vineyard. She girded her lines with strength. She strengthened her arms. She proceeded that her merchants is good. Her counter goes not out by night. She laid her hands to the spindle, and to the hands dug. To her hands holding the staff. She stretched out her hand to the poor. Yea, she reached forth her hands to the needy. She is not afraid of the snow for her household, for all her household are clothed with scarlet. She make herself clothing of tapers. Her clothing is silk and purple. Her husband is known in the gates, and when he sits among the elders of the land, she makes fine lining and linen and sell it, and deliver girded unto the merchants. Stretch and honor her clothes, and she shall rejoice in time to come. She opened her mouth with wisdom, and in her tongue is the law of kindness. She looked well to the ways of her household, and eat not the bread of idleness. Her children rise up and call her blessed, her husband also as he praised her. Many daughters have done virtues, but thou excellent them all. Flavor them deceitful and beauty in vain. But a woman that fears the Lord, she shall be praised. Give her her fruit of her hands, and let her own work praise her in the gates. I just read to you Proverbs chapter 31, verses 10 through 31. May the Lord bless the reader, the listener of his holy word. Let us go to our Heavenly Father in prayer. Father, we'd like to thank you for waking us up this morning and starting us on a beautiful day, Father.
Yes.
Father, we'd like to thank you for my family, Father.
Yes.
Father, we'd like to thank you for my pastor, Curtis Wooten Sr., First Lady Brenda Wooten, and all the members of Amazing Grace, Father. Father, we'd like to bless the Deacon Board at Amazing Grace and all the organizations that we have at Amazing Grace, Father. Father, we just go behind prison walls and touch the mind and hearts of the people behind the prison walls, Father. Show them that you are the way, Father. Father, bless our president, Father.
Yes.
Father, bless our mayor, the governors of this beautiful state of Tennessee, Father, all over the world, Father. Bless this nation. Father, go into the hospital, touch the sick and share in now, Father. Father, they can't do it without you, Father. We need you, Father.
Yes.
Last but least, Father, keep on blessing me, Father, as I go through my trial and tribulation, Father.
Yes.
Keep me, show me, let me be a light to somebody else, Father. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Sunday, happy Mother's Day to all the mothers all over the world. My name is Sister Shirley Faye Cobb, and I am a member of the Amazing Grace Missionary Baptist Church, located at 253 Byron Drive in the Whitehaven community, where Reverend Curtis Wooten Sr. is the great shepherd of the house, and First Lady Brenda Wooten is always diligently at his side. I have been asked to read a poem for you on this Mother's Day, and the poem that I wrote is called The Real MVP. The Real MVP. And it reads, when I was a young girl and while growing up, Mama, I heard you say that in God we must trust. You taught me God's word and how to hold on to my faith, but I didn't know how useful this would be to me one day. And as time went by and the years passed on, eventually I moved out and strayed away from home. And I know there were some difficult times and that I broke your heart. But no matter how Satan tried, he couldn't tear our family apart. So Mama, one day you had a stroke and I knew what I had to do. For it was my duty to care for you and see you all the way through. I felt this was my chance to repay you and to do it with a smile, because I had to show you how much I loved you as your youngest child. See, I remembered when I was sick and how you took good care of me, and that's why I couldn't put you in the nursing facility and then just let you be. No, I had to stand up boldly for you and make them treat you right and make sure you were comfortable until you took your heavenly flight. Thus, in September 2012, you went home to be with the Lord, and your passing away definitely left our family with a huge void. We all cried a river of tears, and yes, we were quite sad, but all I could think of was the possibility that you were in heaven with Dad. So in closing, in my lifetime, yes, I've met some very good mothers, but Mama, when it comes to you, there was absolutely no other. For after all these years, my blind eyes can finally see that, Mama, today I realize you're the real MVP. Thank you so very much. I wrote this because, you know, Mother's Day holds a special place in our heart. And not just Mother's Day, but every Mother's Day, every day. And, you know, regardless of education, accomplishments, or whatever, mothers are still special because they carried us in their wombs. They fed us, they bathed us, they nurtured us when we were helpless and little needy children. My mom went on to be with the Lord in 2012, as I said in the poem, but I'll always remember how I stood up for her and cared for her when we reluctantly had to put her in a nursing facility. My sisters used to say that even though my mother couldn't speak, that when I entered into the nursing home and into her room, it was like she knew that I was there because she came alive and she moved in the bed, and it was like she knew I was there. And my sisters, in their own little way, were jealous of that. And we used to laugh about that. But I'm grateful that my mother knew that I fought for her. in the nursing facility. I'm grateful that she knew that I wasn't just going to allow them to treat her any kind of way. See, Exodus 20 and 12 says, honor your father and your mother so that you may live long in the Lord, your God that it has given to you. I'm just real, real grateful for my mom. I didn't always understand her. You know, in 1907, Anna Jarvis fought to have Mother's Day a celebratory holiday. And that's when it all started in 1907. But I want you to know that every day we should honor our mothers and fathers and be glad and elated that they took care of us in the manner that they did. I'm grateful that I had the parents that I had. I'm grateful for my siblings. I'm grateful for my church members, my pastor and his wife. I'm just truly, truly grateful to God today for what he has done for me in my life. And I just want to say Happy Mother's Day once again to each and every mother here at Amazing Grace and all over the world. Thank you so very much.
Good morning, Amazing Grace women, and good morning, Amazing Grace. I wanted to do something special today to honor and celebrate all the mothers and the women of Amazing Grace Missionary Baptist Church. There are many of you who have impacted my life in such a tremendous and wonderful way, and whether that be by giving me a few nuggets of wisdom, providing a compliment on how well I'm doing as a mother, or just showing me the way of how a mother should be, how a Christian woman or mother should be. And so I want to read this poem. It is not my very own. I'm not that creative as our very own Sister Shirley Cobb, but I wanted to do something special for each one of you. So I hope that you appreciate it and you like it. It's called God's Masterpiece, and it's written by Herbert Farnham. God took the fragrance of a flower, the majesty of a tree, the gentleness of morning dew, the calm of a quiet sea, the beauty of the twilight's hour, the soul of a starry night, the laughter of a rippling brook, the grace of a bird in flight. Then God fashioned from these things a creation like no other. And when his masterpiece was through, he called it simply Mother. So this is for all of the women of Amazing Grace, whether you are a biological mother, a spiritual mother, a godmother, whatever your role is, an aunt, an auntie, whatever. I just want to say to you, Happy Mother's Day, and I hope that you enjoy your special day. Mwah.
Greetings to the amazing mothers of Amazing Grace. We are so happy and honored that you are in our lives. We have put together a special project for you, and we hope that you enjoy. We thank you for loving us. We thank you for giving us birth. We thank you for all that you do and are doing. Please continue to keep up the fight and remember to put God first. Hope you enjoy.
You are our mom, and we love you very much.
You are always there for me when I need you. Thank you for being a loving mother.
You are full of zeal. You are ready to support when needed.
Happy Mother's Day. You are irreplaceable. I am the fruit of your weeks of labor. Therefore, no one can replace your role in my life. Happy Mother's Day.
You are noble, and your heart is as pure as gold.
You motivate me to be my very best, and you will not settle for less.
You are optimistic. You believe in me when I don't have the courage to believe in myself.
You are a good teacher. Mother always knows what's best.
You are a good helper. You are always willing to help me at any time.
You are extraordinary. There's no other mom like you.
Your name is Rodman. I love you so much, Mama.
This is Deacon Paul Wooten with a very special message to all the mothers of Amazing Grace. You are special to your family. You are very special to your church. But most of all, you are very special to God. Happy Mother's Day, and we love you all very much.
Greetings all up to all our mothers at Amazing Grace Missionary Baptist Church. We love you and we miss you, but we want you to have a happy Mother's Day because we are in love with you because you are the greatest thing there is, our mothers. Happy Mother's Day for all and to all good wishes and good will.
I was young, but I recall singing songs was mother's joy as the shadows gathered the close of the day. As I sat upon her knee in those days, there used to be, she would sing of God's amazing grace. Mother was so good and kind. Often she told me I would never find not another who would share my griefs and woes. So I took her at her word. Then I started out to seek the Lord, and now Mother's God is my amazing grace. How sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me.
Praise the Lord. Our Heavenly Father, we come to Thee on this day to say thank You. We thank You for being there for us, being there with us in the time of need. Our Heavenly Father, we want to come before You on this day asking that thou would be so kind to send a word, Father, from on high, that we may be able to preach, that we may be able to teach to thy people. Lord God, we ask that thou would hide us behind the cross. Lord, cover us with the blood. Don't look up on us, but look up on the blood that was shed out on Calvary by thy son Jesus. Go with us, Father. We pray these and other blessings in the name of your son Jesus. Amen. We thank God for this day, this very special day, a day that we set aside to celebrate the mothers of this nation. We thank God for you and for your support of us. We bring you greetings from the Amazing Grace Baptist Church, located at 253 Byron, located in the city of Memphis, Tennessee, in the Whitehaven area. We thank God for you for sharing this day with us. We want to share with you on this day very briefly about a mother who put her trust in God. Again, a mother who puts her trust in God. If you would, go with the book of Exodus, the second chapter, verses 1 through 10. You will find these reading. And there went a man of the house of Levi and took to wife a daughter of Levi. And the woman conceived and bare a son. And when she saw that he was a goodly child, she hid him 3 months. And when she could no longer hide him, she took for him an ought of bulrushes and dabbed it with slime and with pitch and put the child therein. And she laid it in the flag by the river's brink. And his sister stood afar off to wit what would be done to him. And the daughter of Pharaoh came down to wash herself at the river, and her maidens walked along the river's side. And when she saw the ark among the flags, she sent her maid to fetch it. And when she had opened it, she saw the child, and behold, the babe wept. And she had compassion on him and said, "This is one of the Hebrews' children." Then said his sister to Pharaoh's daughter, "Should I go and call to thee a nurse of the Hebrews' women, that she may nurse the child for thee?" And Pharaoh's daughter said unto her, "Go." And the maid went and called the child's mother. And Pharaoh's daughter said unto her, "Take this child away and nurse it for me, and I will give thee thy wages." And the woman took the child and nursed it. And the child grew, and she brought him unto Pharaoh's daughter, and he became her son. And she called his name Moses, and she said, "Because I drew him out of the water." I'd like to share with you today on this Mother's Day, a mother who put her trust in God. Isn't that beautiful? A mother who put her trust in God. As we look at this day, first of all, we would like to say Happy Mother's Day to all the mothers, especially of Amazing Grace and throughout the city, and those of you who are watching us on today. We thank God that you take your time out to share with us on this day. But a mother who put her trust in God. This Mother's Day is a special day, and we thank God ever since the year 1914, when President Woodrow Wilson at that time, made this day a legal holiday, that we should take time out and give special thanks to our mothers. And I say special thanks because this is something that we should do every day. And we should always give credit to our mothers for those who are so hardworking. We realize that the father is the head of the family, but mother is the heart that actually keep everything going. And we know that it is a difficult job, but let me tell you, it is not a burden to be a mother, but it is a blessing. And we thank God not only for those who are able to have children, but also those mothers who step in, who not the biological mothers, but so many times we have them to step in to help us out. And we say Happy Mother's Day to you as well. We know that being a mother is a difficult position. And sometimes you find yourself to be a mediator between even the father and the children, and even the children between themselves. But we just thank God that you just don't walk out, but you sit there and you talk it out until God is able to work it out. How many mothers know that you have gone through some hard times and God has worked it out for you? But thank God for you having to put your trust in God and being able to stay there. What a beautiful thing. As we look at this story, and we're talking about a man named Moses and his father, Aaron, and his mother, Jochebed. They had the son, but at that time there came a king in the land that knew not Joseph. If you go back and you look at the story of Joseph, when Joseph became second in command, and there was only one person that was over Joseph, but he had that much power. And Joseph sent for his brother, his father, and he was able to provide them with the shortage. There was a famine in the land. But look what God did, put Joseph in a position so he was able to help his family out as well. But then as the time continued to go, two things were actually happening here. One of the things, the Hebrews population was starting to grow, but also there came the king who knew not Joseph. What do you mean he knew not Joseph? Because he was not familiar with Joseph. He did not recognize Joseph, and because he did not recognize Joseph, he did not recognize God's people. And because of that, he started putting a burden upon the Hebrews, and he became fearful that they were going to outgrow his people. So he made a creed that every boy child would be put to death. Could you imagine this? Every boy child being put to death. But we talking about Jochebed, who actually put her trust in God. And the Bible tells us that we should trust in God and lean not to our understanding. Ain't God all right? Because God is not, God's word is not, would not go out void. But I want you to know that I stopped by to tell you on this day that if you trust in God, and everything will be all right. For the scripture tells us we should trust in God and lean not to our own understanding. Ain't God all right? We praise God today because there are so many mothers in the Bible who actually put their trust in God. Do you realize that each day we need to put our trust in God? That's the only way a mother is going to be able to survive, if that you put your trust in God. The scripture tells us, for we know that all things work together for those who love God and those also who trust in Him. You need to put your trust in God. I remember the story when Abraham Sarah could not conceive, and she asked Abraham to go in into this maid. Abraham went in to the maid. The maid had a child, and this child's name was Ishmael, and the mother was named Hagar. Hagar had to put her trust in God. Can't you see being put out with just a few items, just a little water, and going not knowing how or where she was going? But on the way, she got lost. But I want you to know today that God will save you wherever you are. He can find you, and He will pick you up, and He will turn you around and place you on solid ground. Hagar went, and then the water was gone. How many of you know that when everything is gone, God can replenish? Can't God, won't God do it for you? But the water was gone. But look at this mother and what she did. Hagar decided that she was going to put her trust in God. And that's what we're talking about today to the mothers. Put your trust in God. We say, hey, God, put in Ishmael, putting him over a distance and look out. And she just wanted to observe to see what God was going to do. If you put your trust in God, he'll work it out. And all at once, something happened. Ain't God all right? She saw something. She thought she saw a mirage, but she saw water coming down. She was able to give water to her son, and he went on to be a great, great, great person. And we just thank God for that. But because his mother put her trust in God, and that's all we're trying to tell you today, mothers. Put your trust in God. We know it gets hard sometimes. We know it gets difficult sometimes. But God will see you through. How many know God will see you through? We just thank God. But as we look at this, and we look at this story, as we realize that Jochebed put her son in the Nile River, do you know what the survival rate would be? But you know what happened? We thank God. Look what happened. God fixes for that Pharaoh's daughter. Now, this is a princess. Why would she be coming down to the Nile River to take a bath when she had everything she needed in the castle? But she may have had everything she needed in the castle, but I tell you, Jochebed had more than whatever that princess had. Thank God. All right. And I look at this princess coming down to take a bath in the Nile River. And when she came down to take the bath, something happened. Won't God make something happen? And then she had sent her daughter, Miriam, who was the sister of Moses, and she stood afar off. Doesn't that remind you of something? What we just talked about, how Ishmael's mother, Hagar, stood afar off. But all you have to do, just stand still and let God fight the battle for you. Anybody ever stood still and let God fight the battle for you? I tell you, if you let God fight for you, you'll never lose a battle. And I thank God today, but that mother had enough courage, but she had faith also. But you just can't have just faith, because James tells us faith without work is dead. But she was not a dead mother, and look how God fixed it. God fixed it up that she was able to raise her own son. She had kept him for 3 months, but the baby was getting to the place that she had to give him up. Could you imagine trying to hide your son, because the king sent the decree that every boy child will be put to death? And then she said, I'll try my chances with God. That's a mother putting her trust in God. She put the baby near the Nile River, and then Pharaoh's daughter sent a maid. And as we hurry along here, I want you to know what she simply did was put it in God's hands. Whatever you got, whatever you're going through, you need to put it in God's hand. And look what happened. God not only fixed it, where the mother would be able to raise this baby, but she also told her, I'm going to give you some wages. In other words, she paid her for taking care of her own child. But let me jump here, and we'll come back to this story. But I want to let you know, there are other mothers in the Bible, and there are mothers out there who have put their faith in God. Keep your faith with God. And there's Hannah who people laughed at her, and she cried out unto the Lord. Doesn't matter what people say, you need to stand on the promise of God. And God said he promised to be with you, and he promised never to leave you. But Hannah sit there and she cried, and during those days, polygamy was legal. Well, man can have more than one wife. The other wives were making fun of her, but she kept putting her trust in God. She prayed and said, Lord, if you give me a son. How many of you ever just called out and say, Lord? Sometimes they say, Lord, have mercy. God knows what you mean. But she kept crying out, and eventually God gave her a boy son. by the name of Samuel. But she specified, I mean, if you give me a boy son, a boy, I will give him back to you. And one thing she did, she gave him back to God. I stop by to tell you today that you cannot be God's giving. The more you give, the more he'll give to you. Can I get a witness here? And what about Sarah? Sarah, who was of age, and she realized that she couldn't have any children, but she prayed to God, and she put her trust in God. God gave her a son by the name of Isaac. As we try to hurry along here, what about Rachel? I remember Rachel cried out to God, put her trust in God. How many times do you cry out to God? The hymn writer say, I love the Lord. He heard my cry and pitied my every groan, but she cried out, and God gave her a son by the name of Joseph. And what about Joseph? What powerful man he came. What about Ruth? Ruth said, went and stayed with her mother-in-law, went back to the land of famine, and she prayed, and God gave her a son, and her son's name was Obed. Anybody remember Obed? Obed was the great 14-time generation of David, King David. And then let's look at Elizabeth, the cousin of Mary. Elizabeth cried, and she was barren, and God gave her a son, and his name was John. You know John, known as John the Baptist. And then last but not least, what about Mary? Mary, who gave birth to our Lord and Savior. So we got a mother here who also trusted in God. But as we go back to the story, as we finish the story, do you remember Moses grew up and he decided that I'd rather live with the afflicted than to be rich and living in Pharaoh's house, because his mother put the trust in him. Moses went on to lead God's people. You don't know what power of mothers that you have, what an influence that you have. Keep the faith and keep the trust in God. Whatever you do, put your trust in God. He will make a way for you. Put your trust in God. He will return a rough place to a smooth place. Put your trust in God. He'll turn your midnights into day. Put your trust in God, and then he'll be a bridge over troubled water. Put your trust in God. He'll be a doctor when you need a doctor. All you have to do is just put your trust in God. And that's all she did. Put her trust in God. The king had sent out a decree, but she knew a king that was king of kings, and she put her trust in God. Look what happened. Mothers, hang in there. Don't give up. Put your trust in God. He will work it out for you. God bless you. Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for all the mothers, Father. We pray you continue blessing upon them, that they may continue to hang in there, that they may continue, Father, to not only to be the mother of their children, but also to serve you. We thank you. Evermore, go with us. In the name of your Son, Jesus, we pray. Amen.
If you would like to continue connecting with the Amazing Grace Baptist Church Ministry, we ask that you comment, click the subscribe button, and turn on post notifications on YouTube. Also like, share, and follow us on Facebook. If you would like to make a prayer request, please join us for our weekly teleconference line, where we open with a prayer and proceed with a study of upcoming Sunday school lessons, as we like to call it, Sunday School on the Move. Feel free to join us on Wednesdays from 5 until 6 p.m. Central Standard Time. You may join by dialing 701-802-5210 and enter the access code 294586 followed by the hashtag symbol. If you would like to sow a seed into our ministry so that we may continue to be a blessing, you may do so through Cash App at $GraceAmazing1. That's $GraceAmazing1. Thank you for tuning in with us, and we hope that you have a wonderful week.